Hi children, welcome to the lesson. In previous classes, we have learnt that water can exist as a solid, a liquid, or a gas. Now, topic for today is states of matter. We say that solids, liquids, gas are three different states of matter. Matter is made of particles. Observe here. Look carefully. What happened to the boy? By this small video, we are able to understand the states of matter. Look here, it is solid. Now it is liquid. And the balloons have gas. There are three types of matter. The different states of matter are due to the different arrangement of particles of matter. There are solid, liquids, and gases. Observe carefully. What happened to the solid, liquid, and gas? Look here. This is solid. In solid state, the particles of matter are very close to each other. That means the attraction between the particles is very, very, very high. So, they are closely packed. Look here. The solid particles hold each other very tightly. That is, there is a strong force of attraction between them. So, solids have definite shape and also definite volume. Now, solids have a definite shape and a volume. Because of the particles are tightly packed, the attraction between the particles is very, very high. Now, let us see the properties of liquids. In liquid state, the particles are packed closely together. The particles in liquids are much farther apart than the particles in solids. That means they are not tightly packed. There may be some gap between the particles. The force of attraction in liquids is weaker than it is in solids. You must remember that the force of attraction in liquids is lesser than solids. Due to this, they can change their shape. Liquids have a definite volume, but they do not have a definite shape. Liquids do not have a definite shape. The shape of the liquids depends on the shape of the container. Liquids can flow easily. They are also called fluids. Though liquid takes different shapes depending on the shape of the container, its volume remains same. Now, let us see the properties of gases. Look here. These balloons are having gas in it. Here, when we are burning the sticks, gas will release. Look here, the gas is occupying more and more space. In gases, the particles of matter are very far away from each other. That means the distance between the particles is very, very high. The attraction is very weak. The attraction between the particles is very weak. Due to this, they can acquire the shape of the container. The force of attraction between particles of matter in gases is very weak. So, they do not have definite shape, and also they do not have definite volume. Gases have neither a definite shape nor volume. They occupy the complete space of the container. Look here. Gases can fill the entire space or volume of a container, irrespective of the container size. Look here. The same gas is filled in this. So, they do not have definite shape and they do not have definite volume. Let us recap the properties of solids, liquids and gases. Look here, solids have definite shape and volume. They do not depend on the shape of the container. The particles are packed tightly together and they are not compressible. That means it is difficult to squeeze a solid into a smaller volume. Only slightly expands when heated. Observe carefully. Solids have definite shape and volume. They do not depend on the shape of the container. The particles in solids are packed tightly together and they are almost incompressible. You must remember these properties. Next, let us see liquids. Look here, liquids have no definite shape. And they have fixed volume. They do not have definite shape, but they have fixed volume. The particles in liquids are in close contact with another, but arrangement is not orderly. That means there must be a gap between the particles. Liquid particles are free to float, thus a liquid takes the shape of the container. That's why liquids are also called as fluids. They are also almost incompressible. We are not able to compress the liquids. And on heating, they may expand slightly. These are the properties of liquids. Now, let us see the properties of gases. They are also not having the definite shape and also definite volume. A gas takes the shape of its container, like a liquid. But the particles in a gas are usually much farther apart than the particles in a liquid. But unlike a liquid, a gas can expand to fill any volume. That means it occupies any container. Because of the space between particles, gases are easily compressed into a smaller volume. Now, look carefully at different objects around us. Look here. There are liquids, solids. We can classify them into one of the three states of matter. Observe the objects carefully. We can classify them. Look here, pencil, eraser, chalk piece. These are all solids. They have definite shape. Here, ink and water. They are liquids. Here, in glasses, liquid is there. And here, balloons are containing gas. Now we are observing three states of matter. Look here, this smoke is gaseous state. Now let us do some activities to understand the properties of solids, liquids and gases. Take a syringe and fill it with some chalk pieces, that means solid particles. Let us observe carefully. We have to crush the chalk pieces. Look here, if we crush the chalk pieces, what happens? We will get some powder. Look here, in the syringe, now we have chalk piece powder or powdered chalk piece. That means it is a solid matter. Observe here. It is powdered chalk piece. Arrange like this and put it aside. And now take another syringe fill it with liquid. We have to fill some liquid in it. Look here. In this way, we have to fill some liquid. Observe carefully what we are doing. You are also asked to do this activity. In the same way, you fit the piston and carefully remove the air in the barrel. Look here, in this way we have to remove the air inside the barrel or syringe. After removing air in it, we have to put it aside. Again, take another syringe and fill it with some smoke, that means gaseous state. In this way we have to fill the syringe. Again we have to fit the piston like this. Put aside. Now we have to close the opener like this. In the same way, we have to close all the three syringes. Now we have three syringes having different states of matters. One syringe is having solid powder and another one is having liquid and another one is having gas. Now what we have to do? Let us try to compress the solid matter. Look here, solid chalk powder, closely packed molecules, it is not compressible. Look here, the molecules are closely packed, they are not compressible. That means solids do not compressible. Now let us see liquid. Liquid here, colored water is there, loosely packed molecules like this, and here also liquids do not compressible. Is not compressible. Now let us see gas. Gases are having large interspacing and they easily compressible. Look here, they are easily compressible. That means we can compress the gases. Solids are not compressible, liquids are not compressible, but gases are compressible. Once again, recap the properties. Solids have definite shape, not compressible. Look here. It is not compressible. That means they have definite shape and definite volume. Now let us see liquids. Liquids do not have definite shape, but definite volume. They are also not compressible. Look here, now gases. Gases do not have definite volume and are also compressible. Look here. Observe carefully. The gas is compressible. Now, let us see the examples in daily life. Here, we find that gases are highly compressible as compared to liquids and solids. By this property, in our houses, liquefied petroleum gas, that is LPG, is used for cooking. Nowadays, CNG is used in many automobiles for all these purposes. Large volume of gas is compressed into cylinders of small volume to make it portable, and also the air in the cycle tube, motorcycle tube and the car tube, they are all containing compressed air. So many ways this property is useful in our daily life. Thank you.